I'm going to show you how to make discrete vector polygons that represent a continuous ephemeral phenomenon look continuous and ephemeral. We'll use effects in ArcGIS Online to do it. First, let me change this default base map to something that uses imagery, but not regular imagery. I'm going to search Living Atlas for the imagery base map ready for data. It's based on the world imagery base map, but its tones and colors have been muted, so it's more appropriate for thematic maps that still need the context of imagery. Next, I'll add my data layer, also from Living Atlas. This is smoke forecast, made available from the National Weather Service. It's an amazing geographic resource that shows the particulate load in the air now and forecast hourly over the next 2 days. One artifact, though, of the vector format is that it draws discrete lines. It has to. But when it comes to visualization, we don't necessarily want to be constrained to this artifact. The vector data format has to draw a line somewhere. So you get these discrete Boolean bands, like these confident fences. But of course, smoke doesn't act like that. Smoke is a continuous phenomenon, flowing from concentrations of more to less. Here's how we can benefit from the utility of the vector format, but also visualize it more like a continuous phenomenon. But first, I'm going to take a look at these categorical smoke colors. Because my base map is reasonably dark, I'd like my data to get brighter as concentrations increase. And because this data is vector, I can change these colors individually to whatever I want. But conveniently, I found that if I use the invert effect, my colors are just about exactly what I want. But the real reason I cracked open these effects is so that I can use the blur effect. There are so many uses for blur in cartography. It's amazing. I'll apply a blur of 15 here, and now my smoke looks smoky. I'm going to get rid of the transparency that this layer came with by default, so it's full strength, and so that I can see through the wispy smoke to the underlying base map, I'll choose the lighten blend mode. Colors that contrast with the underlying base map's tones drive meaning. And with a blur effect, we can smooth out the discrete nature of the vector data type, visualizing it as more of a continuous phenomenon. However, there's a sort of ironic drawback to this sort of approach in that I can't really key visually the data to its categories. How can I sneak back in some of that vector certainty? Even though they're blurry, I can still label them. The data shows discrete ranges of micrograms of smoke per cubic meter. So I'll activate the labels for this to show those particulate ranges right on the map. Now, micrograms per cubic meter might be great from a data perspective, but they aren't the most intuitive. My friend Warren Davison GPT gave me this handy little expression.
Here you go, eh?
To create aliases describing each one of these categories. Readers can always get more details by clicking a pop-up, but this adds an at-a-glance level of utility. And of course, I can always customize how these labels appear. And that is one way that you can visualize continuous data as continuous data, and still benefit from the convenience of the vector data format.